Hello everyone, thank you so much for having me today at SMC 2021. My name is Maxime Poré and I'm a PhD student at the Laboratory for Computer Science Research, or LABRI, of the University of Bordeaux. I'm here today to tell you about some preliminary work we've been doing on the use of sonification to monitor an industrial 3D printing process and how we've evaluated it, given that we're focused as well on the possibility of making it peripheral. This is a joint effort by researchers from Sound and Music Computing with the SCREAM and LABRI of Bordeaux, Cognitive Sciences with the INSIA, and Industrial Technology Research with the STIA Institute of Technology. The machines we've been studying are handled by the platform Adimadou. So first, let's have a look at the process itself. It's a process that consists in manufacturing aeronautical parts out of a titanium alloy using a 3D printing process called Wire Plus Arc. You send high voltage through a metallic wire, which heats up and melts and deposits onto a substrate below. And then it cools off and sets, and you can keep going layer by layer. The parts being constructed need to be structurally solid, so the material has to crystallize properly once deposited. This means that during printing, the operators need to watch the dimensions and temperature of the part by monitoring the criteria that we've detailed on the right of this picture. You've got the local height and width of the welding pool, so the local part where the material is being deposited. You got to make sure that it's continuously following the pattern that it's supposed to for a properly shaped part. You've got the local temperature of the welding pool. You've got the global height of the part in relation to its expected value. And you've got the global temperature of the part, which isn't allowed to pass a certain threshold, because then there's risk that the crystallization of the material doesn't go quite right. Also, you want to be able to tell early if something is not right, because you might be able to salvage the part by interrupting the production and correcting the course. But if not, you don't want to be tossing out too much wasted material, so it's important to know when to stop the machine or not. Overall, this is a rather unfriendly process. You can't look at it too much. There's lots of projections going on. You have to wear protective masks and headphones as well. So as it is, we can't do much in terms of monitoring. So there's been an effort lately to develop ways of augmenting reality to monitor the manufacturing criteria from a safe distance. And in our work, we're especially interested in the use of an auditory display. In contrast with the actual working conditions, we're also trying to make it ambient and relaxing, hence the word peripheral. So here's an overview of the soundtrack that conveys all of our criteria. The aim is to make it so that each sound is easily distinguished from the others, but that criteria that are physically related are conveyed by similar types of sounds. Let's take a closer look. So first, you've got the local geometry of the welding pool being conveyed by an arpeggio in the chord of C major. And if the height becomes too high on the welding pool, the arpeggio becomes higher in pitch. If it becomes too low, the arpeggio's pitch becomes lower as well. And if the welding pool becomes either too wide or too narrow, the arpeggio becomes faster so as to convey some sense of urgency. We chose this sound because metaphorically it reminds us of the way droplets of material are dropped onto the substrate below as the head advances. And here's what it sounds like when everything is okay. And here's what it sounds like if something goes wrong. Then you've got the height of the part being conveyed by a continuous synthetic drone in the note of C. As long as everything is okay, it just remains like that. And if the height of the part becomes either too high or too low, the pitch of the drone follows the direction of the anomaly. And it also becomes louder as the anomaly gets worse. Here's how it sounds normally. And here's how it sounds when the part fluctuates too fast between too high and too low. The local temperature of the welding pool is conveyed by everyday metaphors for temperature on either sides of the extreme, such that if the welding pool becomes too hot, you hear boiling water. And if it becomes too cold, you hear crackling ice. So it sounds like this. and this respectively. This metaphor is also continued for the next sound, which is the alert for overheating of the global temperature of the pot, for which you hear the boiling water actually boiling over and onto the hot plate below, and so it sizzles like this. So here's a sample of what the whole thing sounds like in normal states. And here's a few seconds of an anomaly. So did you catch the anomaly? That was the pot height going down, the whirlpool dimensions becoming chaotic, and the whirlpool also overheating. So did you catch it is the question that our experiment aimed to answer. Did people actually recognize the anomalies when they listened to the display? At the same time, we also wanted to study how well the participants could still carry out this monitoring task using this display while doing something else. Since operators wouldn't have to stand next to the machines anymore, we anticipate the possibility that they could go take care of other things in the meantime. So we built a little dual task game that you can see on the slide here. It takes the shape of a web page with JavaScript elements timing user actions to determine how often they could copy sequences, like on the middle of this screen cap, and check boxes when they could hear anomalies occurring in the sound. Participants, of course, had to confirm that their hearing was unaltered to take part in the experiment. The results of this experiment are shown here. We plotted on this histogram the average error rate at recognizing anomalies for each type of anomaly and for each combination of anomalies that were presented during the experiment. As you can see, the lead arpeggio for the welding pool dimensions was mostly well recognized, but the drone for the part's height was sometimes missed or imagined, respectively, which leads us to believe that it might not be quite suitable just yet. Also, there seemed to have been a bit of a confusion between the overheating of the welding pool and the overheating of the pot in the recognition of anomalies. For a representation of the attentional switch, we plotted the curves of the average number of symbols copied over time, with the vertical lines representing the moment an anomaly starts and the average reaction time to that anomaly, so we can see the effect it has on the performance of the participants. By themselves, the attentional curves don't tell us much for now, but they should provide a frame of reference for future iterations evaluated using the same process. In the meantime, the experiment tells us ways to improve the sound design. For instance, we know that the part height drone conveying fluctuations just by pitch isn't sometimes sufficient, so we should find ways to have the timbre follow the level of urgency, for instance, so the pitch isn't alone to convey this information. It would also be interesting to know more about the learning curve of such a display, how much training would be required to reach optimal performance, and how close to perfect that performance would be. Maybe with a bit more time to learn which is which, some of the errors could be ironed out. Maybe there wouldn't be mistakes at all anymore for the lead arpeggio recognition, for instance. Eventually, we hope to have just the right display ready for when in-situ implementation becomes feasible. In the meantime, there has been talk of experimenting with more simulated implementations, such as the one done here, using a multimodal combination of both sounds and haptic vibrations. That was my presentation on the use of sonification to monitor an industrial 3D printing process. Thank you for listening. I hope you enjoyed it. If you have questions or want to discuss this further, I will be in the chat. Thank you.